Hello everyone, I am Anandim Sharma from Department of Electronics and Instrumentation Engineering. Now, I am going to present the design thinking presentation of our team, Shayan. Our team members are Dhyan, Mallikarjun, Vikas and myself, Anand. At first, let me explain about what actually the design thinking process is. Design thinking is an iterative process in which we seek to understand the user and redefine the problem in an attempt to identify the alternative strategies and solutions. Design thinking provides a solution-based approach to solving problems. The design thinking process involves five major phases. They are empathize, define, ideate, prototype, and the last phase is the testing. Now, let me explain about the first phase of the process, that is empathize. The first stage of the design thinking process is to gain an empathetic understanding of the problem you are trying to solve. This involves consulting experts to find out more about the area of concern through observing, engaging, and empathizing with people to understand their experiences and motivations, as well as immersing yourself in the physical environment so you can gain a deeper personal understanding of the issues involved. Empathy is crucial to a human-centered design process such as design thinking. And empathy allows design thinkers to set aside their own assumptions about the world in order to gain insight into users and their needs. Depending on time constraints, a substantial amount of information is gathered at this stage to use during the next stage and to develop the best possible understanding of the users, their needs, and the problems that underlie the development of the product. Our team carried out the empathy phase by conducting a survey in which 114 people gave their responses. So, here are the list of questions we asked in the survey. The first question was about how much time and on average does the baby take normally to fall asleep? From this question, we could conclude that normally a baby falls asleep in 10 to 20 minutes. The second question was, how many hours does the baby sleep in a day? From this question, we could conclude that the baby sleeps 12 to 14 hours a day. The third question is, does the baby wake up when you stop swinging the cradle? From this question, we got to know the answer was yes. The fourth question is the baby sensitive to faint sound? From this question, we could conclude that the answer was yes. The fifth question is, how often do you wake up during the night to swing the cradle? From this question, we could note that about 32 people woke up 3 times a day. The sixth question is, what are the features would you like to include in the automatic cradle to have? From this question, we came to know that the target audiences needed safety lock, automatic swing timer, camera, alerting message, music, etc. The seventh question was, how much price are you willing to pay? From this question, we could conclude that the target audience was willing to pay 3,500 to 4,000 rupees. The eighth question is, how helpful do you think the automatic cradle will be to you? From this question, we concluded that 50 people gave the rating 5. The ninth question was, how often is your schedule disturbed due to swinging cradle? For this question, we came to know that 47.4% of the people marked sometimes. The tenth question was, what swing speed do you think it is preferable? Most of the people preferred balanced type of swinging. After this survey, we noted down the insights. They are, making baby to sleep consumes time. More often, baby wakes up during night. It takes parents' continuous monitoring. Parents may not work efficiently on their work. Women cannot perform more activities. Parents also gave high priority to baby's safety. They like to have some extra features such as music. Now, the second phase is define. During the define stage, We put together the information we have created and gathered during the empathize stage. This is where we will analyze our observations and synthesize them in order to define the core problems that we and our team have identified up to this point. We should seek to define the problem as a problem statement in a human-centered manner. The defined stage will help the designers in our team gather great ideas to establish features, functions, and any other elements that will allow them to solve the problems, or at the least allow users to resolve issue themselves with minimum of difficulty. So, from the defined phase, we got to know some of the problems that arose and the needs for the target customers. Some of our target customers are working women, baby care center, hospitals, orphanage, single parent, physically challenged women. These are some of the problems arose by using traditional cradle. Manual swings may strain hands, they need continuous monitoring, they would disturb parents' sleep, they cannot provide baby safety, parents cannot concentrate more on their work, may cause infection due to urine, baby may have disturbed sleep, difficulty for a single parent, baby cares fails in monitoring, caring in hospitals is not efficient. These are some of the needs that were demanded by our target customers. Alerting messages, communication should be fast, baby safety should be high, swinging must be regulated, music and playing items is necessary. From this phase, we noted down some of the problem statements. They are: women spend more time in swinging the cradle and carrying babies. 27% of mothers struggled more with baby cry. 71% of mothers said lack of sleep is the hardest of having a newborn. Babies up a lot at night. Disturbance during cooking and office work. The third phase is to ideate. The third stage of design thinking process, designers are ready to start generating ideas. At this stage, they would have grown to understand the users and their needs in the empathize stage, and to analyze and synthesize the observations in the define stage, and ended up with a human-centered problem statement. With this solid background, one can start to think outside the box to identify new solutions to the problem statements that has been created, and can start to look for alternative ways of viewing the problem. The final problem definition we selected is higher priority of baby safety, reduce disturbance for parents while performing their work, reduce the time parents spend swinging the cradle, which causes strain in their hands, and to enhance the experience of the baby in the cradle. From the previous phases, we concluded with some of our ideas for the problems that arose. The ideas are: power supply is used to power the cradle, Arduino is used as microcontroller, Raspberry Pi is used as microcontroller, baby crying is detected using frequency detector, movement of baby is detected using camera, baby's urine is detected using humidity sensor, swinging is operated manually using button, DC motor is used for swinging, pressure sensors used to know the string pressure, orientation sensor used for stability control, Wi-Fi module is used to connect to cloud, gyro sensor is used to monitor swinging angle, thermistor is used to know the temperature, air cooler is used to monitor the temperature, regular heartbeat is monitored, ultrasonic sensors used to avoid collision, stepper motor is used for swinging purpose, MIT app is used for design software, and etc. Now, the fourth phase is the prototype. This is an experimental phase. The aim is to identify the best possible solution for the problems found. We should produce some inexpensive, scaled-down versions of the product to investigate ideas we have generated. The aim is to identify the smart and innovative solutions for the problem identified during the initial stages. Finally, going through the problems and different solutions, we decided to design automatic cradle. In this, we are going to use vibration sensor, wet sensor, temperature sensor, buzzer, fan, and DC motor. Vibration sensor senses the movement of the cradle and initiates to the motor, which will start the swinging of the cradle using DC motor. Wet sensor will detect the wetness of the baby, and the cradle and buzzer will send the signal so that baby and the cradle both stays hygienic. Temperature sensor measures the temperature and controls the fan accordingly, so the temperature of the cradle is maintained and baby is comfortable. This is the block diagram of our prototype, which consists of wet sensor, temperature sensor, battery, vibration sensor and frequency detector, which are connected to the Arduino and thus connected to the cradle. The prototype also consists of the speaker, fan, DC motor. The last phase of the process is testing. In this stage, we test the prototypes. Although this is the final phase, design thinking is iterative. We can often use the results to redefine one or more further problems. So, we can return to previous stages to make further iterations, alterations and refinements to find or rule out alternative solutions. So, the product is up to the expectations and fulfill the needs of the user. The prototype model worked up to our expectations with our remarkable outputs. The real life situation is going to be different. So, some of the different things that we should take while building the real product are adding a camera so that parents can monitor the baby without any hassle, regular maintenance of different sensors so there is no place of error, enhancing the user experience. These are some of the pictorial representation of our simulation and 3D model of the cradle. At last, design thinking has improved our creativity and innovation. It has encouraged us to remove and consider alternative solutions. The entire process lends itself to challenging assumptions and exploring new pathways and ideas to solve glaring real-life problems. Using sensors and other devices, we have designed a device which is advantageous over the manual cradle in most of the aspects. We have successfully implemented the prototype and got outcome. The next step forward is to implement this in a real life scenario for first-hand results. Before implementing it on the larger scale, we believe that this device might completely change the way of caring for babies. Thank you. The next part will be explained by my teammate Dhyan.
Well, for the simulation part, we are using the Proteus software. This is the screen which you get when you open a new project in the Proteus. Now let me add the components. We need Arduino Uno. Next component we require is vibration sensor. For continuous monitoring of temperature and humidity, we are using DHT sensor, DHT11. For continuous measurement of the output of DHT sensor, we are using a voltage terminal or a serial monitor. Next, we need a servo motor. Perform to and fro operation of the swing of the cradle. We are using 3-pin servo motor. For the purpose of simplifying, we are using the same servo motor as a fan. Next, we need a toggle switch. Which we are going to connect to the test pin of a vibration sensor. Another toggle switch for the notifying frequency threshold Now let us do the connections. We need VCC and ground for the components. Here we have a VCC. Here we have ground. Let me connect. VCC and ground. The data pin, we are going to connect it to the pin number A0, which is the analog input pin of Arduino. For servo motor, first pin, we are going to connect it to VCC. The last pin, which is connected to ground. The another pin, which is the data pin, we are going to connect it to pin number 3. This toggle switch we are using to notify whether the frequency threshold is reached or not. I'm going to use another power and a ground over here. This pin, I am going to connect it to pin number 6. Let me connect the test pin. We need another power and ground over here. The output of the vibration sensor, I am going to connect it to the Arduino. Pin number 4. We need another toggle switch. This we are considering as a push button. We have to connect it to pin number 5. Well, this is the connection. We need to load the library for the vibration sensor. This is the library for the vibration sensor. For Arduino, we need to load the code, which is in Arduino ID. We need to verify first. No errors found. Let me save it. Need to export it into to binary format to get the exa file. Also need to check whether the board is Arduino UNO. As it's mentioned, it's Arduino UNO. Let me save it. I'm going to upload this over here. I'm going to connect transmitter and receiver for the serial monitor. Well, that's the connection. Starting the simulation, we get a virtual terminal serial monitor which says the humidity and the temperature at real time. We have kept the threshold for the wet humidity as 70. It's showing 85%, so it's telling wet is detected and it's going to inform the parents. The temperature for here is 33 degrees Celsius. We have kept the threshold as 30, so to do the cooling effect, this fan is switched on. As you can see over here, the fan is going to rotate. Now if baby starts to move, that means vibration sensor going to detect the signals, and in the next cycle of the code the motor will start swinging. As you can see over here, it's going to swing for a while and going to stop then. Now if we decrease the humidity, less than 70%, then in the next cycle it's going to just measure the humidity and it doesn't show any information. As you can see over here, it's showing 66% of humidity and no information regarding the wet. And now if I'm going to decrease the temperature below 30 degrees, the next cycle of the code is going to detect. As you can see over here, it's detected as 28 degrees Celsius and the fan has stopped running now. In another scenario, when place the baby for the first time, the parents have to press this push button, which indicates that baby is placed now to the cradle, into the cradle. On starting the simulation, the servo motor starts to swing for a particular interval of time continuously without any interruption. And when the frequency is detected, which is and frequency is measured more than threshold, which tells that the baby is crying now, then this toggle switch will be on. Then as you can see now, the baby cradle is going to swing again. Well, this was a simulation of our project. Well, we also created a 3D model for our project using a Blender software. This is the model of the cradle. As you can see for here, we have fan for the cooling purpose. This is a speaker for telling the parents or buzzer, giving some buzzer. Here we have attached a frequency detector which detects the signal when baby cries. Here we have a humidity sensor which detects the wet, and a temperature sensor which detects the temperature. On either side of the cradle we have a motorized pump which helps to swing. In the below here we have a vibration sensor which detects the baby's movement. Here we have attached the microcontroller Arduino. Well, that's it for our presentation.